Well, good morning to everyone. Today is going to be Tom's Tips. I had started this video on this Ring doorbell that I had gotten, but I didn't like the lighting and I didn't like the way it came out, so I decided to do it again. We have just gotten over the big cold spell, and I'm sorry, but you Canadians and folks up north can keep your cold weather. I mean, it got very cold here the last week. So I digress. This is the Ring doorbell that my wife had wanted, and I got the Pro 2 several weeks before Christmas and installed it. But I had a couple of, I don't want to say issues, but things I wanted to change when I installed this. First and foremost, this does require an updated transformer. It requires a transformer that has, I think it was 30 volt amps. Most are at 20. You know, the transformer scales it down to anywhere between 16 and 24 volts, depending on what brand, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But my original was 20 volt amps, and the app told me I didn't have enough power to use all of the features. So for $24, I went online, I got the one from them, and that's about an average cost. That's not exorbitant. Installed a new transformer. So you have to know something about electricity in order to put in a new transformer. It's not difficult, but it can be done. So now all the features work. But the second problem I had is I didn't like the way it was mounted. Now, it looks rather benign here, but when I mounted this thing on my siding, and this is old Masonite, this house was built in 86. Let me show you. Get some better lighting here. If you look at the top there, it does come with some shims. There are some, if you have a bell around the corner, some on different forms of siding. Now, if you look at that, you see that that is actually not plastic. I made that. I'm going to show you what I did. Now, if you look from the side, I found that my Masonite siding has a 3-degree, that's too much light, angle of 3 degrees this way. But the shim they gave me was 10 degrees, so it sat out too far. I'm going to tape it next to it and show you. But again, that is not a shim that comes with the kit. I made that. All right, let me take this shim next to it, and I'll show you how I pushed it too far forward. Looking from the side, do you see the difference in angle? I didn't like it pushed forward that much. That's 10 degrees, 10 degree shim. The standard mounting technique left an exposure at the top where this mounting screw is. I'll take a picture of that and insert that. See the screw on top? I think that's completely unattractive. So how can I cover that up? Let's go to the other side here. I don't like that, but I've come up with a couple of ideas to cover that up and make it fairly attractive. I could not find a 5-degree shim. They do sell one, but it's part of a kit of 3 shims, and it does not fit on this particular model. Also, the Pro 2, if you look, there is a rectangular hole. The kit that they sell on the website is a round hole, so it doesn't work for that very reason. So I said, okay, what can I do to make it look like a shim and make it look decorative? Well, you've seen this stuff before. I've used it in my car videos. 3M strip caulk. You can get it on Amazon. O'Reilly's has it. I'm not too much on their spelling. But I use it for all kinds of projects. It stays pliable. It will come off. It's a little tacky. Automotive people call it dum-dum. Let me get a little better lighting there. Let's see. It's hard to get some good lighting today. There we go. Focus. But again, think of it as Play-Doh. So what I did is I rolled it like you do plumber's putty and gently inserted it in there and smoothed it out with my finger. Now, again, it's tacky. So how do I keep it from sticking to my fingers and not pulling it off. I took a little capful of Dawn dishwashing detergent, the blue stuff, wet my finger, and would smooth all the creases out. Now, again, I had a couple creases here, but you tell me where the creases were on top. Hard to see. You really had to be looking. Again, it's a 3-degree angle on this Masonite. I was looking for 5-degree. I had an idea that what if, because that screw was exposed up here, what if I took a piece of vacuum tubing, like you have in your car, fuel line, and stick that over the screw and then mount it? Well, then you still have a gap in here, and you've got the screw covered up by vacuum tubing. Still not attractive enough. My nephew has a 3D printer, so I found out there's a website, Thingiverse, Thingiverse.com, and there are people that do make these. But I could never find one that will say at 5 degrees. It never said. Unless you've got the CAD software, it would be hard to duplicate this and make it 5 degrees. So I said, well, let's just use the old strip caulk. So I just gently put that in there. And again, it is pliable. You'll be able to remove it if you have to. But I think it looks like the real deal. This side. And on that side. Well, I hope that helps. Strip caulk can be a little bit expensive, but I use it for a lot of different projects. And in this case, it worked out quite well. Tom's Tips.
Las Paragus!